Got a chair in here? I'm comfy. Right. I'm ready to roll.
All right, here's the story. What day was it? I mean, I was, as you know, in the L.A. Poker Classic this weekend.
Right.
And out of 800-some-odd entrants, I finished 63rd. Anyway, and it's day two, and I'm smoking all these fools. I mean, Danny Negreanu's kicked out on day one. You know, he doesn't last here. He's really just a pretender. And I got more chips than Phil Hellmuth.
Woohoo!
Even though he's not. And, you know, everything's cruising along. And then all of a sudden, you know, I hate to use public bathrooms, Terry.
I do.
But you play a 12, 13-hour poker day, and you have to give up on some of your principles. I'm going to miss too many hands if I run back to my hotel and go to the bathroom, so I go in the casino. All right. Now, this casino, the area that I go to was the newly renovated area. That's the bathroom I chose.
Good.
I've got to have some small little principle that I hold on to, right? Yeah, so I go to the newer area of the casino. There's some older areas, there's a newer area. And the new bathroom has these bathroom stalls that aren't your typical bathroom stall that you could look under and see if anyone's in there and check out their feet. I'll really squat down low in the disgustingly peed-on bathroom floor.
Like in the sumo stance?
That's right. And look to see if you see any ankles in the stall so you don't, like, barge in on someone.
Right.
But this bathroom is so high tech class situational bathroom experience for everyone who goes pooping or peeing that it has like its own isolated stalls with big barn doors like that go top to bottom so you can't look under anything.
Right.
You know what I'm talking about?
Right,
like
I do.
A real big water closet, if you will.
I don't think I've never seen that though. I can't picture where I've seen that. Yeah. There's always space underneath it.
No, not
never seen
anymore.
That at all. I don't think
anywhere
so. I can't think of it. I always wonder why they don't.
It's not like in a bathroom stall, if you accidentally, if you don't look low and see if someone's ankle's in there and you actually try to push a door open, if you're in there, you kind of like stick your foot up and you block someone from opening the door too far so they don't barge in on you, right? So, I'm jimmying the locks. Okay, first one's locked. Go to the next one. And the next one is not locked.
All right.
I mean, it's not hard to do a quick jiggle and realize you can't really do much with the with the handle there, that's not the kind of jiggle I'm talking about.
No, I gotcha.
It's going to go that way for the rest of the conversation.
Yeah, everyone knows what you have to do to figure out if a door is locked or not.
Right.
All right, well, this second stall was not locked.
Okay.
And I'm prepared now to go in.
The bowels are moving, everything's rolling, you're starting to percolate.
And I'm in a rush because we're in the mid point of a long exerting poker day.
Are we going Wednesday or Tuesday? I just need to know.
Jeez.
I'm going Tuesday,
okay,
or else I'm going the urinal.
Fine, just checking. A lot of people like the stalls to go onesie.
I like a nice stall sometimes when I'm just doing a little piss. So I get
your press.
I thought you would.
All right, anyhow, so I have to lay down a deuce. So I'm going in real quick, and second one is not locked, and I open the door. I fly, you know, fling it open because I'm in a big rush.
Oh, man.
And there's a dude in there. Now, we've all, perhaps, in our lives, barged in on someone accidentally who was just sitting on a toilet, and you're like, oh, excuse me, and you walk out.
Right.
It's happened to everyone. I'm sure if you've lived long enough, you're going to have that happen at some point in your life.
Right.
All right?
Standing point, you're pooing.
just a little quick moment of whatever, embarrassment, whatever you want to call it, but it's not the biggest deal by any means in your life. You're just like, oh, sorry, dude, and you just go to the next one.
Got
all right. Well, this situation was different.
Uh-oh.
Because I opened that door that was not locked.
Yeah, ready to go in.
Now, you probably have your ideas of what's coming. Like, there was some homosexual act going on in there. There was somebody sitting waiting for a little... I mean, you can only have your imagination run in so many directions, right? You probably have your own assumptions on where I'm going here. Trust me. Anything you've considered...
Oh, jeez.
As far as what I saw in that bathroom...
Uh-huh.
Even though I don't want to build it up too much, Terry.
Right.
But anything you've considered is not accurate. All right?
Okay.
Hmm.
Now, give me some of your ideas, just so...
Well, you kind of mentioned them. Yeah, I mean, automatically,
you
assume that, you know, there's... You're catching somebody doing something in the act, or there is somebody waiting and they're thinking you're it.
I mean, let's run the gamut of possibilities of what could have been behind that door. A guy and a girl going at it, you know, some dude bringing some girl that he found in the casino, the ruckus, Terry, and he's kind of, like, pressed over the flusher, and, her forehead is like right on the silver flush lever, and
I wouldn't
every
think
once
it was
in a while
a woman.
Flushes because you would.
I would think that it was a guy. You're gonna walk in.
Yeah,
on,
well, all right, and there
that's
could be
me.
A, maybe you I'm just wondering where your imagination's going. Yeah. Pasties!
Oh, boy.
Oh, dude, I know.
I want to leave you out here, and you have a kind of warped mind.
Pasty's going to nail it.
Stalls,
yeah, he's going to nail it.
Anything.
Like, was there like a barnyard animal or something in there?
Jeez.
He said
a person.
No.
A goat in the stall.
I said it was just one male human. All right.
Oh, dude, that was my weekend. My bad. Sorry, I got confused.
There was no animal of any kind.
Okay.
All right?
Jeez, I'm disappointed.
That would have been good.
And again, wow. I hope I don't upset you, the fact that this story doesn't live up to the hype, but what I saw behind my bathroom door, Terry.
Oh, somebody baptizing a baby in the bowl.
Oh!
No. All right.
Please. I open this door.
Oh, no.
And this dude is sitting there in just a white t-shirt, but he had on just a white t-shirt. All his clothes, his shoes, everything. He had like this particular office shirt that he had all in his arms. Do you see the way I got my arms?
Yes, I do.
Tucked in front of me?
Yes, uh-huh.
His boots, his socks, his pants,
his
Federal Express jersey or shirt, whatever you call that thing,
right.
His professional shirt.
So his uniform is
his uniform, yes, exactly. He's got his FedEx uniform all in his arms.
Like this.
But that's not it. The dude is
not weird.
The dude has got his feet up on the bowl, and he is in a catcher stance while holding all his clothes in his arms with his boots, with his socks, with his shirt. With
so
his,
he's barefoot
with
on the
his
bowl.
Belt. He is barefoot on the bowl.
Ew.
Laying down a deuce.
Squatting
in a catcher stance. Yes,
oh,
in a catcher stance, but holding all of his gear in his arms. And I'm just, I open the door and I'm like, dude, I'm sorry. And I start laughing because I had never seen such a posture, and not to mention the way he was going. But then with all his clothes and his shoes, it was like boots and his belt, all in his arms. And I'm trying to make sense out of this, but I realize it's like looking at the sun. You can't look for too long. You got to get the hell out of there.
So you
catcher stance is a good visual.
So,
one's a fastball, two's diarrhea.
I say I'm sorry, and I start giggling a little bit as I'm closing the door. And then all of a sudden he starts screaming.
He starts screaming,
at me. He goes, "You effing ass!" I got to clean it up, Jerry.
He's yelling at you.
Something's wrong with this guy. I don't know what's wrong with him, but there's obviously something demented about this guy. Because first of all, to be the way he was in that bathroom stall takes a little bit of a warped mind to even get yourself ever in a situation where you got all your gear in your arms and you're squatted on the bowl. But then he starts screaming like a mental patient to me, "You effing asshole! You
right.
And I'm like, "Dude, take it easy. You should have locked the door. What's wrong with you?" I'm actually having a conversation with the guy who's sitting on a bowl in a catcher stance with all his gear, but he's screaming at the top of his lungs now.
Oh,
"You effing ass!" And he's not, as I said, Terry, he's not saying effing. He's saying the full word. "You effing asshole! You effing asshole!"
And
I'm like, "All right." I'm just like, "That's too much for him. This is enough for me. I'm not even pooping
done.
Anywhere.
I'm not even
sticking around. I will hold it in. It'll come out my ears for all I care.
Oh, my gosh.
If this is the only bathroom, this luckily wasn't the only bathroom in the casino, but I'm finding another one. And as I'm leaving the bathroom, I could actually hear the guy in the casino now screaming, "You effing asshole! Effing asshole!"
Wow.
And it was just the weirdest.
You gotta be nuts to not lock the door, first of all.
Mm-hmm.
That's the first sign of being nuts.
And I'm still trying to make sense out of this whole thing to this moment.
Yeah.
Why the guy was in that posture, why he got himself to a point where he got so agitated when he could have just locked the door. It has locks, very simply able to be executed for all that go and squeeze out a heater, Terry.
Right.
I'm still trying to make heads or tails out of this whole thing. I remember the logo.
Oh, jeez.
And he had boots and a belt and his pants and his shirt. And it's all in a big pile.
Weird.
In his arms as he's squatting on the bowl.
I wish he was
squeezing that
I wish he worked for UPS so we could say we know what Brown is doing for him. Damn it, why did he work for UPS?
And I'm still trying to figure out what the hell I saw.